We're all going to be supermen living inside of matrix-like environments, but it's not going to be a prison. It's going to be our ultimate liberation. We will be the gods that we have invented. I'm really a big fan of Ray Kurzweil and his singularity. The term singularity, and there have been several by some accounts, is a term derived from physics to describe what happens when you go through a black hole. When you go through a black hole in physics, the laws of physics as we know them no longer apply. You know, time travel, all these things that supposedly could happen, right? It's a metaphor that's been borrowed to describe when the equivalent happens in the human-machine civilization. So one singularity was the invention of language. Kevin Kelly says that singularity and what happened afterwards, the world after language, would have been inconceivable, impossibly inconceivable to those standing on the other side of that line. I mean, try to tell the non-speaking ape about a Shakespearean metaphor, and that's the level of transformation that we're talking about. So this next singularity, empowered by the convergence of exponentially emerging technologies like biotechnology, which is manipulating the information processes of biology, nanotechnology, which is to manipulate matter at the level of the atom and insert computation into matter, and AI, which is to create non-biological intelligence that's not subject to the limitation of the human brain, the converging forces of those three things are sending us towards what seems to be another singularity as big in scale as the invention of language was. See, information technology is progressing so rapidly, and it's bootstrapping on its own complexity in an exponential way. It's the reason that there's a billion times more computation in our smartphones today than there were in $60 million supercomputers that were half a building 40 years ago. Computation is going to be occurring on scales that can be fit inside our bodies. I mean, we're talking about molecular size computers writing software for our minds and bodies. The confluence of all these things coming together over the next 25, 30 years is going to be trillions of times more advanced than anything that we can conjure up right now. And so we have achieved more change in the last 100 years than in the last billion years thus far. So when you look at what's coming, he says we should call that a singularity because it's an appropriate metaphor to describe what happens when you go through a black hole. And it's like, we don't know what's going to happen after that, but we just know things are going to get really weird. Once we create a substrate that can house human-level intelligence or greater than human-level intelligence, then we can transfer our consciousness over. But that provides like a kind of a paradox, because how do you transfer your consciousness over there? What is left over here? Is it going to be two U's? But Kurzweil has an interesting answer. He says that's not what's going to happen. What's going to happen is that we're going to replace more and more of our biological components with non-biological components. So there's going to be lots of baby steps. So, you know, at first it'll be like, okay, we got this new digital neocortex and we're going to insert it and it's going to merge with your biological neocortex. And then we have this like new synthetic brainstem, you know. That's what we'll do. So eventually more and more of us will be non-biological until all of us is non-biological. And that essentially will achieve the same effect. People say, oh, this is unnatural, the singularity is us playing God. And he's like, wait a minute. People used to be really scared of writing when it was first invented. You know, wasn't it Socrates who said, oh, if we write things down, our brains will atrophy? I mean, when you try to explain a telephone to our ancestors, man, it sounds like witchcraft, it sounds heretical. Oh, you speak words into it and it converts your voice into little things that fly through the air and reach the other side of the planet and reconstructs your mind on the other end so people can talk to you. I mean, the technologies we take for granted today are impossibly complex. I mean, people are already getting like synthetic hips, you know, or hip replacement or titanium knees or whatever. So eventually when we can create replacements that are as complex as parts of the brain, we'll replace those parts. But it's not going to be a prison. It's going to be our ultimate liberation. Imagine radically upgrading our intelligence. Imagine billions of times more creativity. That's what's at stake. Freedom. Freedom from every conceivable limitation.